Welcome or welcome back to Party Trick Astrology. I'm Nina.
I'm Shaina.
And we are continuing on with our Lilith series with Lilith in the seventh house today. We've done Lilith through Aries to Libra, 1 through 6. And I mean, you get the point. I feel like so dumb reiterating everything. It's just like without fail, we'll get a comment being like, when are you doing Lilith in this? When are you doing Lilith in that? And it's like, it's the zodiac, okay? We're doing house, or no, we're doing sign, house, sign, house, sign, house. And this is where we're at. And yeah.
Maybe they know the answer. They're just like, maybe if I ask again, like they'll change their mind and like, you know, do mine next, you know, Lilith, it's like manipulative, maybe. You know.
Regardless, thanks for the engagement, you know, it is what it is.
We've got lots of links down below if you want to get readings from us, that'll be linked down below, our separate socials and our separate channels, and I have a TikTok, and Nina has merch, all that stuff will be linked below.
Yes, so getting into Lilith in the seventh house. Lilith in the seventh house is interesting because with Lilith can come some pretty intense interpretations. And so I feel like we're always making this caveat that Lilith is not the most important thing in the chart. Like all of this intense stuff and the most extreme that we go in any given Lilith is not necessarily going to be what stands out for you. But reasons that Lilith can show up as pretty prominent in your chart and be something, you know, prominent in your personality is if she's in something like an angular house. And the seventh house is an angular house, but the whole deal with the seventh house is that whatever is in it is precisely an energy that you may not recognize in yourself until you're shown that side of yourself through a relationship. So the biggest thing about Lilith in the seventh house is that this energy is going to be something that you experience in other people, in interpersonal relationships, and an energy that is revealed to be a part of you through relationships that you get in.
You will probably attract partners that have stronger Lilith-like qualities, or even a stronger Lilith. Maybe they have more personal aspects to their Lilith. Maybe it's also in an angular house. You know, this can be somebody with rage problems, obsession, controlling. You can even attract somebody with a really bad addiction problem or a mental illness or something along those lines that makes it so that you lose control over your life so much because you're giving so much of yourself to that other person or to that other person's problem. And that problem you are probably the only one seeing because the seventh house is more of a one-on-one thing, so you probably are the one that knows the full extent of it the most.
Yeah, it's hard to get into specifics of how exactly this Lilith energy is going to play out in your relationships without knowing the sign that it's in. You know, Lilith is just obsessive, controlling, takes over your life in a way if you allow it to. And obviously the seventh house, the house of relationships, that's a really important part of anyone's life. It's an angular house. And so naturally when Lilith is showing up in such a prominent area of your life, it's going to be an energy that takes over your life all that much more because, you know, interpersonal relationships, romantic or otherwise, are really important in our experience as human beings. So you're going to want to also look at the sign that your Lilith is in, especially if it's in the sign that is the same as your descendant. You know, using the Placidus system, sometimes a planet or other celestial body or node can be in a sign that isn't the same as your descendant, but usually if it is, it makes a bit more sense, like it's just a bit more congruent in that you attract people with this particular quality, this descendant quality of yours. It's meant to be a lesson to you in how to balance your identity a little bit more. And then in attracting that quality and learning how to balance yourself through that quality, you actually end up getting dragged into the more destructive elements of that quality, or even not just the destructive elements of that quality, of that sign, but just get dragged in so deep into that energy that it becomes destructive, because you never want too much of anything, right? The interesting thing in both Lilith in Libra and Lilith in the seventh house is that this Libran or seventh house energy is so other focused. Like Shayna was saying, with Lilith in the seventh house, there can be an interpretation that you are extremely giving and give yourself over into this partner or into relationships in general, to the point that you kind of lose sight of the practicality of your life or your own individuality or whatever the case may be. But also, Lilith is obsessive and possessive. Lilith wants to be on top, especially because part of the Lilith quantifiers is that Lilith doesn't get to experience inherently its own energy, and therefore she clings even harder to the energy that she's placed into. There's even more of an obsession there. So the kind of exile part of Lilith in the seventh house is being alone and isolated and not having a lot of strong interpersonal relationships. So then when Lilith gets her hands on a strong interpersonal relationship, romantic or otherwise, there can be an obsessiveness, possessiveness, and wanting to dominate that figure. So it can be the case that you get yourself into relationships with people who are just very Lilith-like, and in that they sort of end up taking over your life and you become obsessed with that relationship, and it's maybe a relationship that has some sort of draining energy to where you aren't able to practically go about the rest of your life. Or it can also be that you inhabit the qualities of Lilith in your relationship, in your relationships, in any like strong interpersonal relationship that you enter into, and you feel the need to have some sort of control over your partner, have some sort of dominance over your partner, and become very possessive over your partner. And it's not so much that they have these qualities like mental illness or addiction that need a lot of tending to, but more so that you have the drive within yourself to put a lot of energy into this relationship in order to have some sort of control over this relationship. Not necessarily wanting to be a puppet master in the relationship, but almost more of like this clinginess and this possessiveness because of the, not even just fear of losing it, but because of this predisposition that you might have to think that you're not worth having this relationship, that you don't deserve this relationship on some level, and so you need to cling to it extra hard and devote all that more energy to this relationship to the point that it becomes kind of like an unhealthy obsession.
Yes, and also a huge thing that I've noticed with Lilith in the seventh house, because the seventh house is, you know, it's your shadow side. It's also just kind of what you project onto other people. A lot of times I see these people projecting Lilith qualities onto others, and also even possibly when they were younger, feeling exiled from that Lilith energy, almost not wanting to own their own Lilith energy and instead just put it on everyone else. Like, everyone else is bad. I don't trust anyone. And a lot of times they'll even use these extreme untrustworthiness of others to control and manipulate the person in a relationship. Like, you might hear from a Lilith in the seventh house, like, oh no, I trust you. It's everyone else that I don't trust. And that is a way to control you. That is a way for you to stop the other person from doing what they want to do. And it's through that guise of, you know, being so dependent. I need you, you know, I need you to be safe. I care for you. But it's also just kind of halting that other person's independence at the end of the day.
Yeah, in any unhealthy like balance between the first house and the seventh house, there can be this energy of like not relating to the seventh house, and especially demonizing the seventh house. And especially Lilith is pretty easy to demonize, and also Lilith is pretty easy to put on a pedestal. So it can be the case that you are generally more prone to feel intimidated by other people in relationships and feel like, oh my god, they're so much more powerful than me, they're so much more strong and sexy and whatever, insert Lilith quality in here, than me. Or if you're demonizing Lilith, you can have the tendency to feel like, I'm so much more moral than other people. Like, other people are always so immoral, blah, blah, blah. And in the latter case, where you feel a propensity to demonize other people by projecting this Lilith quality onto them, you might use that as an excuse to behave Lilith-like in relationships, because you feel like, at my core, I'm not this Lilith, I'm my ascendant, whatever that ascendant may be. And it's totally incongruent with this Lilith that I project onto others. But in order to keep up in my relationships, I have to be Lilith-like. Like, I'm strong-armed into this position. Because you are untrustworthy, immoral, whatever, whatever, I also have to be manipulative. I also have to be controlling. I also have to invade your privacy because you're a cheater and you're whatever. So in this relationship, I have to be Lilith in my own way, and I have to. Like, I'm strong-armed into this because you're making me do this. That can very much be a Lilith in the seventh house manifestation.
What can also happen, because Lilith in the seventh house does have these expectations almost of having Lilith-like relationships, it can almost be like intensity and obsession needs to be at the root of the relationship, or else if it's not there, if it's not currently active, it's like they'll be bored and they'll leave. So as much as they can get so frustrated, like, why do I always have these turbulent relationships? Like, why do people cheat on me? Why do I always feel like I need to cheat? Or like, why does this always happen? Like, why can't I just have a simple relationship? Also at the same end of the spectrum, you're also the person that's like, if it's too regular every day, you know, there's nothing Lilith like igniting it, you're bored and you'll move on. You almost need like a challenge or a distance in your relationship. I also forgot to mention, in case anybody cares, I've been dressing for each Lilith video, trying to dress kind of like the energy. For whatever reason, this one kind of stumped me, but I feel like it's like, you know, this demon is saving the seventh house Lilith person, and then it says happy ever after, which I feel like that's your vibe. Maybe this is how you've been feeling in some relationships. I don't know.
I feel like that demon is just like taking the woman off and being like, okay, we're married now. This is how it is.
Yeah.
And the person, the human, is like, no, oh my God, why are you doing this to me? But it's happy ever after, because it's like, low-key, you want that. Low-key, it is something. Whenever something is in the seventh house, like, it is a box that needs to be ticked in a
yes.
relationship. That's why, like, even though the Lilith in the seventh house doesn't necessarily show up in your own character, in your own life, in your own personality in a very prominent way, it does still show up in a big place of your life, in your relationships, and it ends up being something that is a bit more unavoidable. It's not you, it's not something that you even identify with, but it just shows up consistently in your life, which can sound really harsh. It can sound like what we're saying is, listen, you're just going to have turbulent, possessive, energy draining relationships. It's going to be tough, and you're not even going to be happy in a happily ever after relationship. Of course, it's not the end of the road. Like, Lilith in the seventh house and its like worst interpretation is not the end of the road for you, for a couple of reasons. There's always the progress chart, you know. There's also always, you know, aspects and things manifesting themselves in different ways. To be honest, in my own practice, I find it really hard to find positive interpretations of Lilith in a lot of cases. But also, there's always the philosophy of like the untethered soul, of like recognizing that Lilith in your seventh house is a little gremlin inside of you, is a little energy that definitely shows up in your seventh house and wants you to believe that she's in charge. But you can untether yourself from that little gremlin. You can realize that it is not something that is part of you, but that it can be something separate in you that you can acknowledge and quell and not be ruled by. Even though Lilith in any angular house is going to have the propensity or the ability to take over your life more so.
Yeah, since Nina said that she has some trouble with the positive qualities, there are a few positive qualities that I think that can come from Lilith in the seventh house. We're obviously talking about more romantic and sexual relationships, because with Lilith, it's like, you know, Lilith wants to get to the deepest part. She wants emotions involved. She wants sex involved. But we're not always in those kind of relationships. We also have friendships. And I think, especially when you're younger, this can create a group of friends that are mischievous, do fun things, you know, fun things, or they go a little bit too far because it's Lilith. But I'll bet you that you have a lot of really fun and crazy stories about times that you've been with your friends. You guys go out and that's where you feel like you can say all the stuff that you can't say, and you can do all the things that you want to do, or whatever it may be. And of course, it's Lilith, it can go too far. But on the person that's not too Lilithly as it is, your friends might just be a fun outlet where, like I said, you get to say a little bit more taboo things, do a little bit more taboo things, and it might not even be hurting anyone. Something that I will say that I admire about Lilith in the seventh house is that when you have Lilith in the seventh house, you were probably brought up with some form of rules placed around what a relationship looks like. Like, maybe you're expected to fit in a certain gender role, maybe you're expected to marry a certain race or religion or gender or, you know, whatever it may be. And whatever that is, the Lilith in the seventh house will feel like they don't fit into that, that or they don't want that, whatever they're expected to have. And so the Lilith in the seventh house will stand up to that and say, no, I'm not going to conform to this. I'm going to go after who I want in a relationship when I want it, and I'm not going to let your rules that you're trying to impart on me that I don't agree with rule me. You know, and obviously that can cause a lot of friction and everything, but at the end of the day, I think it's good because you won't bend to what society or your family or whoever it may be, what your role is in the relationship or who you're allowed to be with. So those are some kind of positives.
Yeah, definitely. It gives you that independent streak. I think it's funny that Shayna said, like, yeah, we're getting into the romantic and sexual relationships, but you also have friendships too. The thing with Lilith is that, like, any house that she's in, she's gonna make it sexual. She's gonna make it, like, intense. She's gonna make it deep. And so there can be an issue of sexualizing any interpersonal relationship that you're in, specifically because there is this desire to kind of have power over whomever you're in a relationship with. There can be this just like obsessiveness over any relationship that can turn into having a crush on anyone that you're friends with, sexualizing anyone that you're friends with, becoming deeply obsessed with anyone that you're friends with. And in that way, friendships and interpersonal relationships can be very difficult. I mean, like, supportive mutual relationships can be really difficult to obtain because, I mean, the seventh house and Libra, it's all about balance. And Lilith is the antithesis of balance. Lilith will give you a bit of difficulty in achieving that balance in a relationship. And what do I mean by balance? I mean mutuality, any kind of healthy relationship that has boundaries. You can have that propensity to just dive in so deep that you disrupt the boundaries, or there's this theme that we keep bringing up of like the other person is just like draining your energy from you, or you are imposing a lot of energy onto the other person in order to have some control over them. Of course, like, Lilith can also be fun. Like, that is part of what Lilith brings to the table. It's not good, healthy fun. It's fun that ends up being a little destructive, a little harmful. Lilith is that itch that you need to scratch. Feels so good to scratch, feels so satisfying, but you're gonna tear up your skin, you're gonna scar it, you're just not gonna do yourself any practical good in scratching it, but God, does it feel good. The seventh house is really social, and so shit talking, telling secrets that you shouldn't tell. Again, there's that difficulty with boundaries. If you're able to get secrets from people, then it's gonna feel really powerful for you, but you might not deal with those secrets in a very respectful and considerate way. And it might just feel good to like share that gossip or to just, yeah, like talk shit and be in this sort of draining energy that is a bit more unproductive, but can still feel really good to like explore and wallow in. And again, you can be doing all of this, and because it's in your seventh house, feel like you're still not that person. Like, you made me be this way. I'm not really this person. It's totally incongruent with my ascendant, with my identity. It's you. You bring this out in me. And so you can also have this lack of responsibility in your Lilith actions and how they might hurt other people, and might even feel like all that more justified in hurting other people because you feel vindicated because they are this negative energy as well, or they have hurt you, or whatever the case may be.
Also, something with Lilith in the seventh house is because Lilith is that like gut instinct. And so with Lilith in the seventh house, you can have real strong gut instinct and gut reactions to people. And they can go either way. You might meet somebody and you absolutely despise them and you don't know why, or you've just categorized them and, you know, they like this and now you categorize them and you don't like that side. It can honestly lead towards even some discrimination that isn't justified. Now, you would have to look at the rest of that chart because that person would need that in their chart, but that can lend itself towards being somewhat discriminatory. But also the other way, you can have this gut reaction of like, yes, I instantly feel this connection. I instantly like this person. And what's even sometimes cool about Lilith in the seventh house is that somebody that, you know, a lot of people don't like, or a lot of people have instant bad reactions to, that maybe this person isn't even that bad. The Lilith in the seventh house can see that person and not put them down for their Lilith-like attributes like so many other people do. Maybe the Lilith in the seventh house will have a lot more respect for somebody that's dealing with Lilith in the first house than a lot of other Lilith placements. And so in some ways it can be a lot more accepting of like those people with darker qualities and be more inviting towards that, be more willing to hear them out, and that can create a lot more acceptance. But in other ways, there can also be a little bit discriminatory and a little bit judgy in that sense.
Yeah, I think that the core of what you're saying is that as someone with Lilith in the seventh house, you attract Lilith energy. So if you're having like these deep guttural instincts about people, it's because usually the people who are coming into your circle have this Lilith energy, and you can be like, whoa, okay, I know what this is. I've felt this before. Also, in terms of like the respect that you can have for people who take on more Lilith-like qualities, sure, it can be respect. It can also just be like attraction. While other people might put down or whatever people with Lilith in the first house, shame them for being Lilith-like, you can still be like very attracted, because what did we say? Anything in the seventh house is a box that needs to be ticked. And so you see someone with that Lilith-like energy really present in, say, their first house, and you're like, they've ticked this box in me. I'm attracted to that. Now, the judgmental side of that is just dependent on your own relationship with your seventh house. If you are not ready to embrace your shadow side, you will look at anyone with Lilith-like qualities and be intimidated by them, cast judgment on them. Also, your gut impulses of like, this is a very Lilith person, this is a very Lilith person, you can feel that Lilith energy in people, might be very right, because naturally, the people that you end up attracting are going to have some Lilith qualities. But also, the seventh house is a lot about projection. So you can also project Lilith qualities on people who don't have them. Now, to determine whether this is more of a projection or whether this is your gut acknowledging actual Lilith energy in this person, is that usually, if it is actual Lilith energy that your gut is sensing in this person, you will be attracted to them. Like, you can't help it. You can be like, I hate Jake. Jake is the worst person in the world, but you're still gonna make out with him when you go out and meet each other at the club. If you're projecting something onto someone, you're going to project all of that Lilith energy onto them, but at the same time, not have that same amount of attraction for them. And the projecting of Lilith energy onto them is just sort of a scapegoat.
We touched on that Lilith exile phase a little bit earlier, but I kind of want to go a little bit deeper into that because everything that comes from Lilith is coming because she was exiled from that thing first. So this can even possibly represent like a family divorce that really affected you, or even a family marriage that was together when everybody else was like, please separate, you know, and then they saw that clinging on to that relationship and they shouldn't have. This could be somebody that's, you know, very against marriage, or it can go the other way and somebody that's very, very attached to the idea of marriage, you know, depending on what you might also have in the seventh house. Something that I also think that can come from this is possibly because, like I mentioned, the seventh house is everything we kind of project onto others, even things that we, you know, we said we don't feel like we are, that we don't associate ourselves with. So you might have really experienced a sort of sexual rejection when you were younger, like you couldn't connect with people from this sexual Lilith place. You might have even been a late bloomer because of this or something along those lines. This could even possibly be somebody that didn't take into the Lilith qualities until they were a little bit older and they had somebody else show their Lilith to them, because as with everything in the seventh house, you need to be shown it by another person. That might be when you really take on those qualities more, or just kind of go out and do more things and try more things. Can even be something is that's ignited when somebody else shows you that part of you.
There is this assumption sometimes that if you have Lilith in the seventh house, you're more likely to be promiscuous in any kind of relationship. Like I even said this earlier, there's an interpretation where any relationship that you're in, you make it sexual. But Lilith in the seventh house, because of their incongruent identity to Lilith, might restrain themselves a lot and even like wait for marriage, even like not get into relationships that aren't from the onset going to be deep and committed and whatever. Like some people who wait for marriage, they'll wait for marriage, but they'll date some person for like 2 months and then at 19 get married and then it's straight into the deep end. So that can be a way that Lilith manifests itself in the seventh house. I'm not saying that anyone and everyone who dates for 2 months and then goes straight into marriage at 19 years old then has like a Lilith-like relationship, but it's a way that it can play out where you, again, have that feeling of exile, have that feeling of abstaining from that Lilith energy, and then you get into a relationship and it goes deep, fast, obsessive, all of these things. Maybe because you are with someone who is waiting to have full control over your body, mind, and soul, and then they sort of like absorb you and bring you into like this Lilith experience, or potentially you're this person who is waiting to have kind of like a supple, naive, young thing to be able to absorb yourself and control and have power over.
You only know how to relate to people through this sexual style, like Nina was saying. What can come about that is you related to somebody in a sexual way first. People can always put on you that like, yeah, you're gonna be my mistress, or I don't know what the male version of that is, my mister. Even if you're somebody who doesn't want to be that, you might get put in that position a lot, and because it's Lilith, you're gonna be like, you know, scratch that itch and wanna keep going. Or the tables can be switched and you can be that person that's always like, you're my mistress, you're this, you know. It goes both ways.
No, that's literally every single seventh house interpretation is like, it can be this, where you're doing this, or it can be this, where you're experiencing this and this. But at the end of the day, it's actually just always both. It's always both. It's depending on whether you acknowledge that that is part of yourself or not, that the other person is igniting something that is already within you or not. But it's always both, actually.
Yeah, I think some of my biggest advice with that Lilith in the seventh house thing is that you have to do work to accept your Lilith qualities and understand that Lilith part of you and not continuously just project it onto other people. Not that other people aren't bringing that into your life and not that things, you know, and I'm not saying like everything is the other person's fault, but you need to accept that part of you, you know?
Yeah, because if you're at the effect of something, of someone, or of this energy or of this pattern, you don't take like responsibility for it, you're never going to be able to grow past it. It doesn't have to be a part of you. It can just be this entity within you that, you know, if you feel like it, sure, indulge in it. Share some good gossip if you just need to scratch that itch. But do it consciously and know when to stop, at least.
All right, so let's get into some celebrities with their Lilith in the seventh house. The first one that I want to mention is Kurt Cobain. I honestly don't know too much about Kurt Cobain, but I was like, I know their stuff with his relationship with Courtney Love. Like, I probably know more about that. I looked him up just because I was like, oh, I want to know some more specifics about the relationship and what actually went down. But the first article that came up when I searched Kurt Cobain relationship, and it was called The Destructive Romance of Kurt Cobain and Courtney Love. And I was like, already, that's some Lilith shit right there. And also a lot of people mentioned when they talked about the relationship, like how controlling Courtney Love was. And like, I don't know the intricacies of the relationship. Of course, none of us do, but just the fact that people are willing to talk and put that all on her. And I don't like Courtney Love either, so I'm not trying to, you know, talk this girl up, but it's just crazy that people would put those qualities onto her, because he has Lilith in the seventh house. So she's the one that's getting all those qualities put onto her. And he's almost like, yeah. Another person with Lilith in the seventh house is Madonna. And when you search Madonna, so many articles about all the men she's dated come up. Her Lilith is in Pisces, so there's a lot of artistic types that she's dated. But also her first marriage was to Sean Penn, and he also has his Lilith in the seventh house. So I thought that was really interesting.
Yeah, Madonna and Sean Penn, I know, had a really abusive relationship. Like, it was a really abusive, unhealthy relationship. But what's funny is that they both have Lilith in the seventh house, and it's not the first thing that you think of. Like, for me, it's not the first thing that I think of. Like, Madonna is such a, like, Leo presence to begin with, that the first thing that you think of is not like her abusive relationship. And Sean Penn as well. My friend knows Sean Penn, and I heard about their abusive relationship after I already was like 2 degrees away from Sean Penn, and it was like so surprising to me as well that, like, wow, Sean Penn and Madonna. It's like, it's, to me at least, it's not the first thing that I think of when I think about either of them, even though it's like such a huge thing. So it's really interesting that they both have Lilith in the seventh house. And so it's like, it's not the first thing that you think about them.
Yeah, like you said, it doesn't have to be the most dominant thing, but also kind of back to that thing that I said, it's like only the two of you might see all this stuff going on, you know, because it is so interpersonal that it's like they only know what really happened. Chrissy Teigen has this in Gemini, and Demi Lovato has this in Pisces, and they treat people like shit. Like Chrissy Teigen is in Gemini because, if you don't know, like, she says ridiculously mean things to people on Twitter. There is this TV show, and in the TV show, this 16-year-old girl was with this really old guy, and it was obviously very predatory. It looked like he was drugging her. It was a lot. And what did she do? She went and attacked this woman, this 16-year-old girl, on Twitter, and told her to kill herself, told her all these horrible things, was absolutely relentless. And, you know, it's in Gemini. Gemini Lilith, y'all can just say shit.
That's a really great example of the projection of Lilith and that justifiability, because you can understand the reputation of this 16-year-old girl. She looks like a Playboy bunny. She has this like Lilith vibe. And so that's the projection of Chrissy Teigen putting it on her. And like, she's Lilith. She's the one who's all Lilith. And so in this situation, I can project it all out into her, but really she's behaving in that really toxic Lilith energy. And as well, Chrissy Teigen recently went under fire for tweeting really sexual things about toddlers and tiaras back in the day. Not even necessarily sexual, maybe, but just like inappropriate. And that just shows you the like lack of boundaries Lilith in the seventh house has in any person that they view, and just the propensity to sexualize anyone.
Yes, and how far Lilith will go to justify itself. Like, what extent it's willing to go to, you know?
And again, it's easy for her to, like, Listen, they're the ones sexualizing toddlers and tiaras. They're the ones doing this. They're the ones like putting them up into costumes and glitter and whatever. But it's like, just because they're doing that, not everyone is like taking the action that you're taking. And another thing about Chrissy Teigen and her relationship with John Legend is that their relationship is the poster child for anyone who wants to say, you can still have sex with someone on the first date and have it be a relationship. Like, that's what I always hear all the time. There's a lot of science that people will bring up about, like, you don't want to sleep with someone on the first date if you want commitment, blah, blah, blah. And then the argument that a lot of people combat that with is like, that's not true in all cases. Take Chrissy Teigen and John Legend, for example. She was in his music video. They had sex the first night. I don't even know why that's like public knowledge for everyone, but it is. And now they're married and they have kids. And it's like, yeah, you're taking the example of someone with Lilith in the seventh house. So. Yeah.
That's so funny. That is so funny how much of this shit is just like all aired out.
Yeah. I think it's like also Lilith and Gemini a little bit.
Oh, it's yeah. Like, Just saying shit. The next person is Rob Zombie, and he has this in Capricorn. I think that his obvious fascination of horror is kind of Lilith in the seventh house, because there is a side of Lilith in the seventh house that is like always having seen the darkest depths of people. You understand that people have this Lilith inside of them and will express it in really gross ways, and you've seen that from a young age. So I think that possibly a fascination with horror, specifically the gross things that people can do to other people. You know, all his movies are literally about that. House of a Thousand Corpses, like it's literally just those three people and all the nasty shit and how gross they can be and what they can do to another person. Also, he always puts his wife in movies, and it's in Capricorn, and it's pretty obvious, at least to me, that they kind of have more of a working relationship, that they're together because he thinks that, like, you know, she's just absurdly hot, and so she is highly sexualized in all of his movies, is one of the main people in all of his movies, and let's be real, Sherry Moon is a bad actress, let's just say it, but he's always gonna put her in there because it's Capricorn, it's this working relationship. This one's a little bit more heavy, but, you know, we gotta take it to the extreme. World War II has Lilith in the seventh house in Pisces, and it's a highly discriminatory war, and it's in Pisces, so it was discriminatory towards a certain religious group, and in the seventh house, you know, going to extreme hatred of another person or another group of people. And also, I think we look back at this as a reminder of how cruel humans can be to other humans, which was also that thing that I was talking about with Lilith in the seventh house, recognizing the cruelty of people and how far that can really go.
Yeah, it's also interesting that the entire idea of World War II is that you had to put down this entire group of people because they were unfit or they were somehow like evil or whatever. But in that process, you become a type of human that is so unfit and evil.
On a more lighter end of the spectrum, I guess, Zooey Deschanel has this in Virgo, and I feel like this is why she gets that manic pixie dream girl trope. Is that not this?
I'm sorry, but like the lack of segue between World War II, Zooey Deschanel.
I tried to say this is very different. Let's go. Okay, we're hopping in. But don't you see what I'm saying? Like, I feel like that manic pixie dream girl. Like, she's independent. She's autonomous. She's crazy. She's quirky. She's, you know, it's in Virgo. She's gonna do what she's gonna do. She's gonna save me. Oh, and then oh no, she's autonomous. You know, like she's going off on her own now, and she slipped away from my fingers. Because, you know what I mean? Okay, and then, okay, there was a crazy, I don't know what the fuck this is, and maybe Nina, maybe you'll be able to interpret this more, but there is a crazy amount of celebrities, of famous people with Cancer Lilith in the seventh house. A disproportionate amount of celebrities had it in Cancer. I don't know why.
Name some. Do you have any names?
Yes. Naomi Campbell, Jimi Hendrix, Gwen Stefani, Zac Efron, Diana, Princess of Wales. Like, they're all kind of coming in from different places.
Yeah. This gets into conspiracy theory stuff, but, like, you know how there's this idea that there's a pedophilic elite?
Oh, yeah.
They don't all fit into the same thing where they came into... Like, Zac Efron came into fame quite young.
Yeah. I think they all did. Well, I don't know about Diane. I don't know her age. But, like, Gwen Stefani was young. Jimi Hendrix, like, he died when he was so young. He had to have been young. Naomi Campbell, I mean, she was a model. I'm sure she was, like, an illegal age. You know what I mean? I'm sure this was child.
Yeah.
Like, child abuse there.
Leave your conspiracy theories in the comments. What is the connection?
Yeah. Also, a weird connection here. Now, this is Astro Theme. I've mentioned this before. Astro Theme has some crazy, you know, they put some crazy people up there. But two entities that supposedly have Lilith in the seventh house are the Antichrist and Virgin Mary. Two sides of the same coin, maybe? Virgin Mary's is in Cancer and the Antichrist is in Virgo.
So the Virgin Mary is another celebrity with Cancer in the seventh house. That's what you're saying.
You do with that what you will, okay? Oh, also, in an extreme way, because Lilith can always go to extremes, as we like to mention, Richard Ramirez and John Wayne Gacy, two notorious serial killers, both have this in the seventh house. I'm sure their Lilith is pretty overcharged too, that they're so obsessive and controlling with people. They reject the natural balance of a relationship, so much so that they want enough control over the other person that they get to decide if they live or die, they get to have sexual control over them, all that kind of stuff. Also, John Wayne Gacy's is in Gemini, and if I'm not mistaken, he was the one that was into underage boys, is that correct? He also has crazy amounts of Pisces. Richard Ramirez also has crazy amounts of Pisces.
You know what else? They both had head injuries. I don't know if that has anything to do with astrology, but they both had head injuries. They're just part of, like, that group of serial killers, where you're like, a bunch of these serial killers have had crazy head injuries, and you're like, what the heck is going on there?
Fucks with their Aries energy, you know? Fucks with their dominance energy.
Just fucks with their brain. Like, come on, let's be real.
I'm gonna try and end on a little bit of a nicer note with these celebrities. After that fucking mic drop. No, I'm kidding.
No, the fact that we went, what did we do? We went World War II, Zooey Deschanel, the Antichrist, some serial killers. It's like,
it's a range. That just shows it's a range, you know what I mean?
No, it's not even so much that it's a range, it's just that Zooey Deschanel is just in the middle of, like, all of this shit.
Maybe there's some stuff we don't know about her. No, I'm kidding.
Yeah, that's Lilith in the seventh house, along with some banter about why a lot of people have it in Cancer as well, who have fame. Again, like, this is just a general interpretation of Lilith in the seventh house. There's so much more to your Lilith, like the sign it's in. We do have Lilith through the signs in this series. Depending on when you're watching this, they might all be out. And if you want a more personalized interpretation of your Lilith, book a reading with one of us. NinaBAstrology.com to book a reading with me. Astro-Freak.com to purchase a reading from Shayna.
Yes, thank you so much for watching. We'll talk to you next time. Bye.
Bye.